Ladies and gentlemen, this is Experience All, this is Demexco. We have great speakers, great topics. And if you go on stage, if you have somebody on stage, lots of people coming in, the house is packed. You cannot behave like that. This is not ERR, this is not the Frankfurt Auto Show. So we need some energy, we need something great, because the next topic will be great and the speakers will be great. We cannot behave like that. So let's do it like they do it in Hollywood. If the first thing doesn't work, we do another one. I'll be off stage, I'll be back, and you all know what to do. Welcome, everybody! Welcome to the Demexco! Welcome to Experience Hall! Thank you very much! Yeah, that's the spirit I'm talking about! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, we will talk about things are changing. Digital is changing everything. We don't know what to do, but we are lucky. There are some people who do know what we can do and what we should do. And we are very lucky in the next topic when we're talking about the thing called ads. How to deal with ads. Everything is changing. And you know, because you guys look good, you behave good, you know how to applaud, we are grateful and tell you, we brought you the best you can get in terms of ads. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a gentleman who is so smart. I had a hard time following him, but I know you can follow him, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome on this very stage, Dan Taylor, Managing Editor of Global Display Ad. Dan!
All right.
That's all yours.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody. I need to bring you to all of my meetings from now on. What a great way to start. And thanks, everyone, for joining me here at the Experience Stage. It is great to be back at Demexco. Not my first trip to Demexco or to Germany. This is my fourth trip to Germany for business or for pleasure or both. Like many of you, I tried to plan out my trip in advance and think about what was my flight going to look like? What was my hotel going to be? How was I going to get to and from the airport? I asked Google about the weather, and I looked into who else was speaking here today. Soon, I was reading articles about things to do in Germany because, thankfully, I'm spending a little bit more free time here in Cologne this time. Because this is the first time I've had this opportunity, I was really interested to know what I could do. So I searched on YouTube, Cologne in a day. What did I find? Cologne in 5 minutes. I've always appreciated that German efficiency. This is what I discovered. There's a chocolate museum right around the corner. So I decided I'm going to head over there and bring home a souvenir for my wife. My wife loves chocolate. And she also hates that she wasn't able to come on this trip with me, because last time I went to Demexco, we also made it over to Oktoberfest. And so I'm pretty sure this won't be as good as Bavarian beer, but I'm hoping that chocolate from Cologne will come in a close second. So if you were a marketer trying to figure out how to get people to buy chocolate, this is a pretty roundabout way that I got there. But I wouldn't say that it's unusual. I think we'd all agree that the consumer path to purchase is not linear, probably never has been, but is increasingly more and more fragmented with lots of different touch points, especially given all the different ways that you can consume content today. These types of journeys are the norm regardless of the product or category that your business is in. And so the question for us here at Demexco as digital marketers is how can we become more than just a single touch point, but instead shape that customer journey in a way that drives better results for you. So consumer behavior is evolving, and I'm here today to talk about how marketing can and should evolve with it. Traditional channels, like television and radio, are evolving and becoming more addressable and more digital. How can we think about taking the ways that we market today on television and radio and apply some of the best practices from digital marketing to reach consumers along their journey? Today, people are more comfortable engaging with technology in new ways. They're discovering content through feed-based experiences. They're having conversations with technology and are expecting to get more in return immediately. How can we deliver better marketing experiences as consumers expect that more real-time engagement. And looking further forward, think about the next frontier. We all now carry a high-quality digital camera in our pocket at all times. What are the opportunities for marketing, given how much communication has evolved using that camera? You're going to hear from my colleague Alex about some exciting things that we're doing in 3D and augmented reality. Let's start with consumers and how they're spending time. Over 10 hours, or close to 10 hours, a day consuming content. I had to think about whether that was true for me, and I'm pretty sure that it is. 10 hours a day is a challenge for marketers to navigate, but it's also a great opportunity because this is where we're reaching consumers. Now, as the how with consumers engage with content evolves, digital marketers have an opportunity to expand how they reach those audiences well. Again, trying to shape that customer journey as it hits multiple touch points, even on channels that were traditionally considered more offline. Let's start with TV and radio. I did. I started my career in traditional broadcast advertising before moving into digital. It wasn't quite that long ago. There you go. That's more like the 1990s when I started in the advertising business. One of the reasons I was drawn to the digital space is because of the ways the technology could deliver more relevant advertising and better results for marketers. And also, consumers were spending more and more time online. But today, the tools are catching up, and you're able to apply some of the great things about digital to channels that were more traditionally seen as linear. This year, half of all German households own a connected television. And worldwide, people watch over 250 million hours of YouTube every day from the living room. With Google's Display and Video 360, our enterprise media buying tool, you can now reach those users in the living room as they're watching live events, as they're watching their favorite TV shows, not just on YouTube, but on premium content broadcasters globally, including in Europe. One new inventory source that I'm particularly excited about being able to reach addressably is Disney. I'm a big Marvel fan personally. As of this fall, you'll have an opportunity to streamline your digital buys across Disney's portfolio, including addressable television and connected TVs, through Display and Video 360. But what makes connected TV really exciting for me is that you can bring the best practices from digital into the living room, taking a data-driven approach to reach the right audience, to plan, buy, and measure your television audiences right alongside your digital and online video campaigns. And to make the best of both worlds, we worked really closely with the IAB to design industry guidelines for audience segmentation, for frequency management, and measuring in a privacy-safe way across all of these different channels at once. Now, TV programming isn't the only place that we're using new technology to reach people on media that you traditionally think of as traditional. Mobile and voice are changing the way that people consume audio content as well. Audio can be a traveling companion, a workout buddy, and a way to keep yourself entertained as you're doing the laundry. I listen to Spotify and Pandora as I'm commuting to work each day. In fact, 1 billion people will stream music this year. So much of that is driven by mobile devices that you're carrying in your pocket. These connections with users are intimate, and they need to be customized in a way that can be most effective for your brand and resonate most with consumers. But historically, one of the challenges with audio advertising is the amount of production that you have to do in order to make it workable for your local markets. Testing out messaging, reshaping it for the local markets, and distributing it out to those channels. So as we're developing this new opportunity, earlier this year, we launched the ability to buy online audio, podcasts, online radio, streaming, right alongside your digital campaigns. And we're exploring some ways for you to scale that creative as well. Let me show you one of the things that we're experimenting with. So let's say you work for a CPG brand. This is the part where we see if the demo works. Yes. Okay. And you're launching a new chocolate bar. You want to promote it as people are commuting on their way to work. You like the copy that you've created, but you're not sure that it's going to work and resonate really well in all the different markets that you're looking to buy. So you hop into this tool inside of Google, and you enter in the text for your radio ad or your audio ad. We've already done that up here. Hard to read. But here, you can also pick your narrator, male or female, right? The type of tone that you want to set, and even the type of accent that you'd like the narrator to have. Let's go ahead and pick German. Then you can pick some music, whether you want an upbeat chocolate ad or something that's a little bit more serious in tone, depending on that region's opinion of chocolate. From there, you're ready to go in seconds. You've customized an audio ad for a specific market. Let's give it a listen.
You love chocolate, you love your smartphone, but you're worried about pocket space. Well, worry no more. Introducing the Chocolate Pixel from Google. Coming soon to a museum near you.
Chocolate Pixel is not actually in beta, but we'll do what we can. So while we're still in development on this, it clearly looks into making sure that you can buy audio scalably alongside your digital video campaigns, including scaling your creative, high quality, customized for your market in seconds. So I already figured out how I'm going to spend most of my free time here in Cologne. So I stopped actively looking for things to do as I started preparing for today's work. But I'm still open to hearing new things before I head out of town tomorrow. In fact, that's pretty common in what people are expecting now from their internet experience. They are open to discovering new things at any moment. 3 out of 4 consumers tell us they're open to discovering new products and new services that are relevant to them at any time. I don't know who the 4th is, but everyone has had this experience. This is why we announced Discovery Ads earlier this year. It's a new way to reach people while they're discovering new content across browsing and swiping on Google consumer products such as YouTube, Gmail, and the Discover feed, all using a single campaign. It's about reaching consumers when they're looking to discover something new. An early adopter of this product is Brillen, a German eyewear manufacturer. With creative assets from their social campaigns, they use Discovery Ads to quickly scale their digital marketing campaigns, and they're seeing amazing results, increased volume, and new customers that they wouldn't have reached anywhere else previously. And not just Brillen. We've had other customers that have really adopted this early on and are seeing amazing results in terms of conversion volume, new customers, and more. We're so excited about the opportunity with Discovery Ads, and that'll be available globally by the end of this year. Make sure you stop by our booth in Section 6 here at Demexco, where you can learn a lot more about Discovery Ads. Now, feeds aren't the only way that consumers are engaging with content a little bit differently. We're also thinking about how ads themselves can deliver more of an experience that fits with how consumers are engaging. We see more searches today that are conversational than ever before. We see more people turning to chat to get answers in real time because they don't want to wait for an email response, right? And so this is why I'm excited about an incubator product within our company called AdLingo. One of their moonshot products is called Conversational Display Ads, and it leans into this consumer's increasing tendency to want to chat with brands to get information in real time. Users simply type in a question right into a display ad format on desktop or mobile devices, and they can receive helpful answers right in the moment that provide a more meaningful interaction. The average interaction time with conversational display ads is 1.5 minutes, the polar opposite of the historical banner blindness problem. So we have innovations across connected TV, across audio, new interfaces like browsing and conversational. These are all ways that technology is adapting for marketers to reach consumers where they are today. That's what's happening now. Now I'd love to introduce Alex, who's doing some amazing work in the augmented reality and 3D space to get you thinking about what's next. Come on up.
Thank you. I'm kind of bummed out that the band is gone, but you know, maybe in a few years I'll get one. So, okay. So if you think about how technology has developed, the lesson for brands is quite clear. We always have to keep our eyes on the next shift. So let's think about how we interact with computers. So initially, if you want to ask a question to a computer, we had to use our hands through typing on a keyboard or tapping or swiping on a phone. Now, we also can use our voice to ask a question. But next, we're expanding into a new sense, which is vision. How can we build computers that see like humans do and also can communicate through sight? Why would we want to do this? Well, because sometimes a question is really hard to ask in our own words. So for example, what is this thing? Are there more things like it? What can I do with it? Or where do I need to go? So I'm from Mainz in Germany, which is pretty much the same as Cologne, just where you have Fasnacht and not Carnival. But I live in San Francisco, and I go to New York quite a bit for work. And if you're familiar with New York, you probably know that the best way to get around is the subway. So whenever I leave the subway, I use Google Maps for my walking directions. And now what happens then is that Google Maps tell me to go south. Now, my parents have taught me a lot of things, but I have absolutely no idea where south is. So what do I do? Well, I do this one, right? Or I just start randomly walking into one direction till, there you go, the blue dot moves the right way. We call this the blue dot problem. But today, with Live View in Google Maps, I actually can just take my phone up, it will realize where I am, and then display the information right in my environment. So no more misdirection, no more misturns. Let's take a step back here. It's not that maps aren't useful, right? Or hopefully I'm not that unintelligent. But the problem is that the way how information is displayed on those two-dimensional maps has nothing to do how you see the world around you. So it's actually quicker to just start walking than take this information in, think about it, and then decide where to go. So by adding vision to maps, we actually can make it much easier to understand and can give it back to the user so that they, you know, can take action. All right. So the technology that enables this is the camera, right? And the camera is in all of your customers' pockets and handbags at all moments in time because it's on smartphones, which creates this massive opportunity. The question is, though, what can we do with it? So let me show you what that can mean, our two largest platforms, which are Search and YouTube. On search, over the past years and decades, we've been working on making those search results richer and better, right? We've added videos and pictures and other things. But what is really hard to understand is actually get a sense of dimensions or size. So if you might be wondering, how small is a Shetland pony? Or how big is a shark? Now, actually, with AR and search, you can place that shark right in your environment. And actually, I happened to be working from the Sydney office last week, and friends of mine took me wakeboarding in the morning. So about 5:30 or 6 o'clock in the morning, and which is shark time, because sharks hunt at dusk and dawn. And as I was telling, you know, my friends and family about it, they got pretty freaked out. I haven't really been bothered, but now that I've seen this thing in my environment, I probably should have been quite scared. Anyhow, so for you as a marketer, what can you do? Well, you can now show from search how would that couch look like in your customer's living room, or how would that Volvo look like, you know, in their driveway. And as you know, it's pretty hard to actually buy a couch and return it, because in this way we can just solve it much quicker and easier. In order to get started, you need 3D assets. And we've been working on new ways of scaling those 3D assets on Google's properties. So we've been working with Dan's team, the Display and Video 360 team, on actually developing a new ad format called Swirl, which is essentially 3D banners. And what you see behind me here is a campaign from Galen, and which we just launched a couple of weeks ago. And we asked ourselves the question, how can we make the scent of a perfume visible through a banner ad? So we came up with this. And what we've seen in the early alpha is that actually, compared to normal 2D banners, 3D display actually has a significant uplift in brand lift. So it's essentially a rich and immersive ad format, which is good for upper funnel, mid funnel awareness type of campaigns. Okay, let's talk about YouTube. Why YouTube? Why augmented reality? Why the camera? Well, so there's obviously tons of YouTube content out there, but what if we could do more with that content? And specifically, product reviews are like a good way to learn about products, but what if you could actually try them on or try them out right there? And so we started with beauty. The reason for beauty is because there's this fundamental user problem, which is, how does this makeup product actually look on me? And that's what everybody wants to know, which is why there's so many different beauty videos out there, how a look is created, or creating a look for a specific occasion, such as a wedding or an interview even. So what we did is, we actually took the camera and put it right into the YouTube app. And so you can try on products right there. So Dan, may I ask you to come back on stage and demo this with me?
What, am I going to try on some glasses or something?
Almost. There you go.
Okay, thank you. Can you unlock it? Okay. YouTube? Which one?
Yes, YouTube. So the rule about demoing on stage is never demo on stage because things will go
wrong.
Right,
there you go. Okay. So I got the phone on here.
So this is Dan. He's watching now his favorite YouTube beauty tutorial.
All right. So try it on. Sure.
Yeah.
Anything happening?
Say okay. Yep.
Oh, right. All right. There I am. Okay. Oh, that's not really my color. Let me try this one instead.
Unfortunately, so this should actually be working much smoother, so I'm not entirely sure whether all your phones are doing this, but
I think
you
it looks
have
pretty
a
good.
Live view.
Sort of a cabaret look.
Yeah, cabaret look.
All right, cool. So I think I'll buy that.
All right.
All right. So shop.
Right.
All right. Coming. All right, there it is.
Thank you.
All right, so I can buy it right here.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Dan.
Thank you. Don't share.
Beautiful, yes. We just send the pictures to everybody you know. Okay, so by the way, this should be much smoother, but you can try it on the YouTube Makeup app. Actually, you don't see a picture, but you know, you see your whole face and everything. You can, you know, blow kisses or whatever you want to do. All right. So we trialed this in our early pilot with three different brands across three different creators. And we had high expectations for the results, but the results absolutely blew us away. So 30% of all people who were shown that try-on button actually tried on virtual makeup, which means that they tapped the button and then gave camera permission. And when they did so, they tried on 11 lipsticks in every single session. And more importantly, every single brand of the three brands that participated with us saw a significant uplift in sales. So as I mentioned, the results, they even surprised us. And if you compare the 30% try-on rate compared to any CTR benchmark that we have, this is absolutely mind-blowing. Which begs the question, why are those results so strong? So think about this. There are all these YouTube beauty creators out there. And they come in different shapes and colors and forms and genders. Somebody like you, or somebody you want to be like, or somebody you trust. And you come to watch her try on makeup. And then she says, by the way, you can try on this product with me right there. So you tap that button. And then she looks great. You find a shade you really like. And then she says something along the line of, I have this creamy feel on my lips. And then you convince, and you actually buy that lipstick, right? So we think that this is a perfect way to actually get consumers right from awareness through consideration to take an action. All right, let's summarize here. So Dan and I spoke about both new and familiar ways of how to reach consumers, right? So as a digital marketer, you can now use traditional channels such as TV and radio to custom tailor your ads and reach the right audiences at the right time like you can do in digital. Secondly, there are now new ways to engage with audiences, right? Whether audience are scrolling through a feed or taking a picture or having an actual conversation with an ad with a weird German accent, they're more engaged with technology than ever. So you as a marketer, you just don't need to show up there, but when you do, you also need to be engaging, right? So don't just be a touch point, but shape the consumer journey. Vielen Dank. Thank you very much. Auf Wiedersehen.